This is Bryce, leader of the Gutless Gang, and today we're going to talk about anxiety that's related to your body. I want to talk about how to get rid of the anxiety that's related to you feeling like you're not in the shape you want to be in before actually having to get into shape. And so the funny thing is, if you can see, I'm starting to thin a little bit right here. And this has been caused by an addiction to nicotine. So for the last 6 months, I have chewed approximately 1 to 1.5, sometimes 2 tins of Zyns, which are these tobacco-less little nicotine pouches. And I go with the sixes. The sixes are 6, I think it's grams or milligrams. It's not good. It's a lot of nicotine per little pouch. I'll do 2 at a time. And I would do an entire can or a can and a half a day. And nicotine constricts your blood vessels. So my hair started falling out. But I was addicted. So I kept eating or chewing these little things and my hair kept falling out. And then just this week, I quit. I quit on Sunday. It's now Thursday. And I'm not as worried about my hair falling out. And it's not because it stopped falling out, but I just stopped checking it. Like before, I'd get into the shower and I'd be terrified of what was going to happen. And typically what was going to happen is I'd see 3 to 4 hairs in my hand every goddamn time. And it would freak me out every goddamn time. I'd go, shit, I'm losing my hair. But the thing that I've realized was really causing the emotional reaction, a lot of fear and just frustration and angst about losing my hair, was the fact that I wasn't doing anything to help myself. In fact, I was doing the opposite of helping myself. I was making the problem worse. Now, there's no guarantee that the only reason my hair is falling out is because of my nicotine addiction. But in continuing to pop those things into my mouth, knowing that it could be the cause, I was feeling really shitty about myself and terrified about the prospect of losing my hair. But now that I've done everything I can do, which is stop chewing those goddamn little Zyn pouches, I don't feel as fearful. I don't feel as anxious. The angst has gone away. I've done everything I can do. So how does this relate to you? Well, if you are still eating crappy food and you're not exercising and you're not fighting back, and not only are you, you know, not doing anything about your problem, you're adding to it by continuing to eat crappy foods and drink sodas and do all the things that you know are going to cause you to get worse. Well, your anxiety about your body, your fitness, how you look, how you feel is going to keep getting worse. So what I know is when guys enter into the Gutless Elite 8-week challenge, they instantly feel better, even though they haven't lost any weight. They're taking action. And we always harp on this point. The antidote to anxiety is action, right? So if you are feeling anxious, the best thing you can do is confront your problem head on and do everything you can to start getting your hands around its neck. And this very violent metaphor, I'm just going to abandon that one, to start doing everything within your power to solve that problem. So my hair loss, I'm not tripping. I'm not worried about it today. Because I'm doing everything I can, I'm not chewing nicotine. And if it keeps falling out, then it keeps falling out. There's nothing I can do about it. But I'm taking action. I've already done everything I can. So with you and your body, if you want to feel better, I promise you, you can take some small actions to at least not keep contributing to not looking the way you want to look and packing on more weight. Then I promise you, you're going to start to feel better. Day by day, you will feel a little bit better. I'm Bryce, leader of the Gutless Gang. Go to gutless.com/book to check out my book. Just released it. I help busy dads who love to eat lose 10 to 30 pounds in just 8 weeks by boosting their testosterone naturally, ditching the dad bod and going gutless. 5 fingers make a fist. Wish me luck. I hope this hair comes back. And I wish you luck with your weight loss goals as we move into the holiday season. I'm here to help. Leave a comment and I'll be sure to get back to you.